2, 4.
That was not.
Yeah. Let's get exposed.
Welcome to Transmissions from the Void, Transmission 138. Open your ears to the emptiness that you weren't even aware you were searching for. Listen. The Void is calling.
Somewhere for somebody else's money? I make the money, man. I rule the nickels. The game's mine.
They wound up taking acid together. Evidently, Mike started getting belligerent with Charles Manson. They've been drinking too. Mike says that they were playing keep away with his soul. Manson chased him up into the hills with an axe. says that they were playing keep away with his soul. Manson chased him up into the hills with an axe. And Mike ran up in the mountains and found a cubby hole to get into where he wound up spending 3 nights there.
Doctor.
Joined in that spiritual activity. Unfortunately, these were not my friends, and these were not an exchange of musical ideas and so on. These people were inherently screwed and lost and evil.
Let's get evil! Let's get evil!
Nobody watching. Love like you never get hurt. Sing like there's nobody listening.
I can't do it. I was waiting for the end of this.
Live like it's heaven on earth.
Let's get evil! Let's get evil!
Thank you.
need work like a club. I've been hurting like a mud. Opportunity is in the mud. And dirty out here for this 40-hour shit. Sweep and scrub, I'll plunge out shit. Right out the check, still on the bus. I stop his niche. Get off and I walk by the block. Still loading a bitch. Fuck up the squad. Hope they don't know that I'm hot. Cause my eyes heavy, eyes cherry. You know that I got me some drops. Let me try to focus. And I hope they don't notice. Cause I'm
up too much CPU.
Nice.
What's that?
You climbing a rock.
Just like
old Spider-Man out.
Probably unplug this shit too, eh?
Das Beats, yeah.
Ciggy Smoke.
Ciggy Smoke.
That was fucking techno jam sesh. I drank some absinthe that sucked me very. And then have a cig.
I'm gonna be smoking through this whole set. Because it's one of the loopholes in the law. They keep in the smoking beds, they keep, if it's part of a theatrical production, a loophole in the law, because they don't want to fuck up some faggy Tennessee Williams production and ruin the integrity of the show. So they leave this fucking loophole open for me. If the cigarette bothers you because you're envious, vote next time. How about that? Vote, yeah, every now and then. figure out what the fuck's going on in your community.
Well, I have decided.
No, you don't vote. You got shit to do.
For my talents.
Leave it to old people with breathing problems who will never come here.
Well, I have decided. I have better use for my talents.
Your fucking generation is so unbelievably sad. If you're just getting to like partying age, you're fucked.
Well,
there's nothing going on in this country anymore.
It's
done. Last call. It's just a suck generation. It's the most boring fucking generation in the history of people.
Well,
it's all dumbed down and wanted.
When's
the last time you heard stories about rock and roll bands chucking TVs out of hotel windows or any of that shit that used to be fun? Like, there was fun in the world. Some of this is going to make me sound like a grumpy old fuck, and I am, but I have just cause.
I have better use for my talents.
As people get older, the older you get, the more bitchy you get. Because that's just natural. The more you've done shit, the more jaded you get. But I think we're going to be the first generation of old people. As soon as someone gets old, they complain about the new kids. And, these kids today, look, they're crazy. It's always that the new generation was too deviant. These kids are out of control. They're crazy. They're immoral. Look at what they're doing. In our day, if we wanted fun, we just went to a barn dance. And we didn't even finger fuck till we were like 35 years old. But these kids today... It was always that the new generation was over the top, and we're going to be the first generation of elderly people complaining, but in the opposite fashion, where we're going, look at these kids today, these half faggots. We used to do crank off of titty dancers and shit. No one got hurt. We had a lot of fun. We got some good stories and herpes out of the deal. It was a fucking good time. The blisters bring me back. These pussies, they drink a Red Bull for some pep, and they'd prefer if you went on the patio for a cigarette. And the closest they come to a fist fight is on a message board somewhere. You looking at my girl? I'm gonna delete you from my MySpace, friend.
Jeff a blonde user in your future, faggot. Tex Watson, Susan Atkins, Linda Kasabian,
they're about to start piss testing for adrenaline in the workplace. That's how sad this country's getting. Shaking your urine in front of
Manson's you. Yeah, you're still on the extreme cloudy.
Have you been having fun on the weekend? Are we not enough bugs for you here at the Verizon Wireless family? You need to seek it elsewhere? I don't think you're a team player. That's why I love hearing people go, oh, that town, that's like 20 years behind the times, that fucking place. Book me there. I had fun 20 years ago. But I can still smoke indoors? Ecstasy still pure, uncut, and readily available? Oh, shit. What cavemen they must be.
Because it's like the motorcycle. Anybody who has any kind of sensuality in them at all would get a tremendous boot out of just what the angels call screwing it on. Getting a big bike and just running it flat out as fast as it'll go. I used to take it out at night on the coast highway. I was drunk out of my mind, ride it for 20 and 30 miles, just short pants and a t-shirt. It's a beautiful feeling. I recognize it as an illusion and a fantasy, but for somebody who has nothing else to go back to, this is maybe one of the happiest minutes of his life. And you can imagine, if that's true, just how powerful he'd feel if he could give you one of these, in the head with a karate. It's not a chop, it's a head snap. The angel, a lot of the angels are big on karate.
Hunter Thompson, our guest, is a new kind of journalist. The journalist who is not detached, who becomes involved. In fact, he was almost an honorary member, or a dishonored member, of the Oakland Hells Angels. You were with them for about a year or so.
About a year, yeah. They claim, the angels anyway, claim that they don't look for trouble. You know, they just try to live peaceful lives and be left alone. But on the other hand, they go out and put themselves into situations deliberately and constantly. that are either going to humiliate somebody else or cause them to avoid humiliation by fighting.
You speak of foul fighting. They stomp someone. You were stomped. In which there isn't a question of rules involved here. Just beating some violence for the sake of violence.
Well, they have a rule. It's bylaw either number 10 or 11. It says when an angel punches a non-angel, all other angels will participate. So I was a victim of bylaw number 10 or 11. Yeah. I should have known that. You know, yeah. It's a lapse of caution. All during this stomping, I could see the guy who'd originally teed off on me just out of, you know, from nowhere with no warning, circling around with a rock about, oh, must have weighed about 20 pounds. I tried to keep my eyes on him because I didn't want to hit my skull fracture.
Your observations are more than about the angels, they're about our society. And it's since World War II, pretty much, isn't it, this phenomenon's come to be?
I think the angels came out of World War II. And this whole kind of alienated, violent subculture of people wandering around looking for, you know, either an opportunity or, if not an opportunity, then vengeance for not getting an opportunity. Yeah, they get to be 30, and suddenly they wake up one morning and they realize, you know, there are no more chances. It's all gone. It makes them meaner, you know, and they want to get back at the people who put them in this terrible, this dead-end tunnel.
Now, who are these people they want to get back at?
Oh, they don't know. It's kind of they. Paranoid. You know, it's you, it's me, it's whoever might come too close to him on the highway in a car. It's somebody who makes a remark in a bar to him. It's what they call them, the citizens. Anybody who looks respectable and looks like he isn't doomed. You know, like he has some kind of option or money or a home or all the things they don't have.
When you see the rest,
everything. He comes to me with money in his hand. He offered me. I didn't ask him.
I'm not really very optimistic. But I think one of the most important things is to recognize that we do have this mounting violence in us, and then to find the reasons. And once you find that, it's like curing a boil. You know? And if people insist on saying I am a very gentle person and only these little back gang of hoodlums over there is ugly and mean, then it's just putting off the recognition of the same venom that the angels are spewing around in public. A lot of people are just keeping bottled up in private. I think this technological, what, the science of obsolescence, or the fact that people are becoming obsolete, the people who are most affected by this are the ones least capable of understanding the reasons for it. So the venom builds up much quicker. It feeds on their ignorance. Until you recognize what's happening, you know, what makes you do these wild things. Christ, I used to throw beer bottles into bar mirrors and stuff like that and get stomped always. I can't remember ever winning a fight. I don't do it anymore because I finally caught on to what was happening. And until you recognize
the musicians assemble, the albatross around your neck. First incredible Bongo Band album took place at Cannondale Studios.
Yeah, I learned a lot about myself.
Better known as Mushroom Studios.
I'm seeing a very ugly side of myself.
The case with the incredible Bongo
Band. I'm much more conscious of the kind of anger that lurks all over everywhere. I don't do any, you know, I keep my mouth shut. I turn into a professional coward. Call the Hell's Angels in Oakland the only violent part of our society. I think Lyndon Johnson is, you know, be a good Hell's Angel. The angels reflect not only the lower segments of society, but the higher, you know, where violence takes a much more sophisticated and respectful form.
They kill all those people. It's very nice. It's nice. Something else will ever be. And you live anywhere. They liked me, they wanted me to become part of what they were doing. And I sat in a circle around a campfire with those people to record their songs.
Flatline. Flatline. Flatline.
Okay.
Three, two, four.
Let's get exposed.